Hi, this is a video tutorial on how to update firmware for our branded DMA card 75T. To do this, you will need some files that you can download on our website. The link will be in the description. If you have a card from another brand, you will find text instruction for flashing it in our DMA Cheats folder. After you have installed the DMA card in your main PC and made sure that it meets these requirements, connect the USB 3 cable to the JTAG port of your DMA card. Connect the other side to USB 3 port of your second PC. On the second computer, go to this folder and install the driver. And move this folder to the desktop. This is a mandatory step, don't ignore it. Move your firmware file to this folder. Next, run this tool in the FPGA column. Select XC7A75T. In the middle column, change from bit to bin. Then click this button and select your firmware file. Click this button to start flashing process and wait until the process is complete. It may take 3 to 4 minutes. After the process is completed, turn off your main and second computer and turn off the power. Switch on the power supply to position 0 or pull the power supply cable out of the socket for 30 seconds. Switch USB cable to the data port on your DMA card and turn on your main and second computers. Some firmware requires to install a driver on main PC. If you bought firmware from our website, the manager will send you the driver. For some firmware, driver is not required or it will be installed automatically. After installing the firmware and driver, I recommend clearing the history of previous devices connected to your main PC. This is necessary in order to erase the data of previously installed firmware. To do this, run PowerShell as admin on your main PC and enter this command. Press Enter and wait for the process to complete. After this, reboot your main PC. Now let's test your DMA card. On the second PC, go to this folder and run Lone DMA Test. Select 1, Full Test. As you can see, everything is working and the speed is great. If the test was failed, try restarting both your computers using a different PCI Express slot, a different USB 3 cable, and a different USB 3 port on your second PC. Then you can repeat speed test. If the test still fails, most likely there is a problem with your DMA card or firmware. I don't recommend using cheapest cards from untrusted stores. If you need a high quality card or firmware, you can buy them at dmacheats.com. It was a video instruction for updating the firmware on DMA card 75T. See you in the next videos.